If you're thinking about becoming an actuarial science major and becoming an actuary, then I strongly suggest watching the video to the end to find out what I wish I knew before I finished my actuary degree, because no one ever told me these things. Hey everyone, it's Brian. In this video, we're talking about all things actuarial science. So I'm going to preface this video with my experience is just that. It's my experience. It might be totally different than yours, and things might have changed quite significantly since I went through school and did this. So just throwing that out there. Most of you watching would know that I've finished my undergrad as a math major. What you may not know is I was fortunate enough to double major in actuarial science. Technically, my degree was risk management, but what we really did was actuarial science. And this brings me to my first thing I wish I knew when I was becoming an actuary major, was just how easy it would be to double major and even minor in other things. I don't say this to brag at all, but I was able to graduate in 4 years with a bachelor's in math, a bachelor's in risk management, actuarial science, and a minor in statistics. Now that sounds like a lot, but with correct course placement and correct decisions in those courses, it really wasn't that much extra effort as it might seem. You see, the actuarial science majors require so much math, so much statistics, that those classes made it very easy to just go ahead and get that math degree along with the actuary degree and get that stat minor along with the actuary degree. When I graduated, I think it was around 150 credits that I needed to complete both those bachelor's and that minor. And that might sound like a lot, but a traditional degree is about 120 credits, which means I only needed 30 extra credits to get the extra certification. Comes down to about one extra class a semester. And the way you can do that is by taking cross-list classes. Those are classes that are going to count for both of your degrees or minors in question. Thing number two I wish I knew was how similar actuarial science was to statistics. Now, obviously, math, statistics, actuarial science, there's lots and lots of overlap. But the way the degree was marketed to me through advisors and advertisements and those sort of things was that it was a very mathy major. I'm much more of a math person than I am a statistics person. So when I think of math, you know, I think of pure math, I think of calculus and differential equations and complex analysis and proving mathematical theorems, these sort of things. When it comes to actuarial science, it's very similar to statistics. You're using lots of probability distributions, lots of conditional probabilities, lots of financial mathematics, and not as many more pure math things like integrals and derivatives. Those things do come up. Much more of the math you're doing is more statistical, which is absolutely fine. It's just not exactly what I was going for necessarily when I signed up to be in the major. In fact, I think many people who want to be actuaries nowadays will just do a statistics degree or do a master's degree in statistics because the things you learn in statistics are so applicable to actuarial science. Which brings me to the third thing that I wish I knew is that so many different fields seem like they can just branch into actuarial science. Whether you're a math major, a statistics major, a risk management major, probably other majors, as long as they're sort of analytical in nature, as long as you have an analytical background and are able to pass the actuarial science exams, more on those later, you probably have a good shot at becoming an actuary. I think if I realized how flexible my degree would be, I might not have gone exactly down the actuarial science degree path. I might have just stuck with my math major and focused more heavily on that rather than spreading myself a little too thin. Don't get me wrong, I think if you have an actuarial science degree, you can probably also do other things, but it seems like many analytic backgrounds can help you become an actuary, even if your foundation wasn't necessarily in actuarial science. Now, getting into the actuarial science exams, they're such a big part of becoming an actuary. When I was doing it, you needed about 5 exams to get a certification. I think it's a little bit different now. I think the structure is totally changing. So when you're watching this video, the structure might be totally different. Now, people will tell you that these exams are hard. They certainly were hard for me. I think when I was taking them, the pass rates for these first few exams were something like 40%. You know, not everybody is passing these exams. And so the main thing I really wish I knew about them was the cost. You see, they're not cheap to take, and the higher you go with them, it seems the more expensive they are. I think the first few were around $150 when I took them, and they're just gonna get more and more expensive to maybe hundreds and hundreds of dollars. I'm not sure. I'm sure you can look up all the prices. But I didn't realize just how expensive these exams were. Not to mention, if you fail them, you have to pay to take them again. Now, what'll happen is some schools will reimburse you if you pass the exam. Often employers will simply pay for you to take the exams. But if you're a college student and you're trying to pass all these exams and you're paying for them out of pocket and you're not passing them on your first try, that's very expensive. I didn't realize how expensive it was going to be to become an actuary, because I'll tell you, I did not pass the exams on the first try. I only ended up passing 2 actuary exams before I jumped off the bandwagon. And it took me a number of attempts to pass those exams. Along with the cost of exams, I wish I knew about the cost of resources to study for the exams. When I was studying for the exams, there were not a whole lot of ways you could really study and purchase resources. It's not like there were many tutors tutoring actuarial science. There are not many professors who teach actuarial science. So what you're sort of forced to do is buy study manuals, which are very expensive in themselves. There were and are a few online web course sort of things, but those were very expensive, especially because, you know, I was a college student. It's not like I had a whole bunch of money to spend on material trying to pass these exams. I really didn't realize how few resources were available to help prep for these exams unless you wanted to spend a lot of money. Again, most employers will pay for these things, pay for these resources, or reimburse you for them. But if you're just an actuarial science major and you're not hired as an actuary yet, well, then you're kind of out of luck. Now, getting into the actuarial job field itself, I'll admit I never was hired as an actuary. I had an actuarial internship, a retirement actuarial internship, for about 10 weeks over the summer between my junior and senior year of college. And this was probably the most eye-opening part to the actuarial science career for me. See, as I was going through, I was much more of the math-focused track. You know, like I said, my channel is about math. I was a math tutor. I am a math tutor. I like doing pure mathematics, whereas actuarial science is a very applied math. Now, my advisors and certain marketing for actuarial science sort of described the job as very great for mathematicians and math people. And I think that is true, because you need a level of mathematics and ability to pass the actuarial science exams. If you're not proficient with math, these exams will be very, very challenging. So in that sense, you really do need that mathematics background to be an actuary. But when it comes to being on the job, at least as an intern, I used almost zero mathematics. And this was sort of a shock to me, because I thought in my head what an actuary was sitting down and doing computations and calculations and figuring out models and that sort of thing. And I'm sure that is true probably at a higher level, but at least what I was doing, which was entry actuarial work, it was very similar to almost any corporate job. Whereas all the formulas and all the math you needed was already programmed into the computer, so you really didn't have to do any math on the job. I really wish I knew how little math was involved in day-to-day work. This brings me to my next thing I wish I knew, that being an actuary is essentially like a corporate job, any other corporate job, just that you have to take these exams to keep continuing with your career. Now, that is a double-edged sword. It's bad that you have to take exams if you really want to advance in the field, but it's also very good because there is that opportunity. Not everyone will be taking all the exams and pursuing their career further and further. So it's bad and it's good. It kind of just depends what you want to do and how far you want to go with it. But I wish I knew just how similar it was to many other jobs out there. Specifically on the job brings me to my next point. I really wish I knew how important Microsoft Excel was going to be on the job, or whatever spreadsheet program your company would be using. Pretty much exclusively, all of my work was done in Microsoft Excel, a little bit of Microsoft Access. And this is really what I mean when I said that there wasn't a lot of math involved. Microsoft Excel had all the formulas and everything programmed in. You were essentially just working with spreadsheets. Now, my teachers in college told us about Excel. They tried to train us in Excel and a little bit of Visual Basic, a little bit of coding, these sort of things, because they said we'd be using it on the job, but they really didn't tell me how much we'd be using it on the job. You know, like that's like 95% of my work was in Microsoft Excel. So you become proficient fairly quickly, but it really helps to know what you're doing in Microsoft Excel or a spreadsheet program with all of the formulas and the keyboard shortcuts, this sort of thing, just how much you're going to be using it. Next, I want to talk about something that I never expected was the pressure from my university. At my senior year, it was very important to my school, which was Penn State, had an internship and two exams by the time they graduated. Now, I did meet those requirements by the time I graduated, but there was a ton of pressure. I remember getting emails and emails reminding us about this invisible requirements, reminding us that we should be preparing and scheduling our exams, and if we weren't going to take an actuary job after college, we had to make sure to let them know what we were doing. It was just a lot of pressure because I believe the university had some certification that so many of their students had done these things, and it looked really good for the school. But I just never expected that the teachers would be so on you to keep going and keep grinding, and it was a lot of pressure, to be honest. And that leads me to my last point, which is I wish I knew how burnt out I was going to be by the time I finished my undergraduate degree. Doing the double major thing and pursuing the internship and trying to go after all of these actuarial exams, and not to mention try to balance any sort of social life and everything else that's going on with college. By the end of my 4 years as an undergraduate, I was totally burnt out. It's very easy, I think, to get burnt out as an actuarial science major, mainly because of the exams, the actuary exams that you're studying for just outside of your normal classes. So if I had to go back, I probably would have done things a little bit differently. I think I would have given myself a little bit more of a break, try to take some pressure off myself. I definitely think I didn't have to be as burnt out as I did. It's certainly doable to finish the degree and complete as many actuarial exams as you want without getting so burnt out. But I wish I knew just how easy it was to get burnt out so quickly from all the curriculum. I do think becoming an actuary is a great career move for many people. It is rated as one of the best jobs out there in terms of salary and benefits and employee satisfaction. I think if you can land a job and get through the exams, it can be a really great thing. It turns out it wasn't for me. I wanted to go a different route when I was done with school, but I hope this video helped you out, helped you make a decision. I appreciate you watching to the end. I picked out some videos over here that you might be interested in if you want to check them out, and I hope you have a great day.